police department mission is to provide a safer community and a better environment for people to live in and be able to flourish and do their day-to-day routine.
Police have to quickly react to dynamic situations. In the future, even their gear will work to protect them from unexpected dangers. Lightweight layers will provide protection from bullets and sharp objects, while sensors will monitor their health status and location. This will allow individual officers to monitor their own fitness and allow command to see the status of all officers responding to an incident.
First responders having situational awareness improves their safety because, again, it provides them additional information for which to apply to that specific incident.
Body-worn video and facial recognition will make it possible to find known criminals or suspects, and augmented reality glasses will allow future officers to stay engaged and aware of their surroundings while receiving notifications of potential threats.
I've got eyes on a robbery suspect at Pleasant and Main. I'm in pursuit.
When a police officer gets a job, he's not going to be able to think, hey, I need to get an additional piece of gear.
Hey, hold a second.
What he has on him is what he has on him.
Tagging and tracking technology will make it easy to document the details of the incident and pre-populate an arrest report. A suspect bracelet will monitor vitals to alert nearby officers if the suspect is in distress.
The system's old and we're still doing pen and paper, and there's a move for the department to move to a more robust system that's going to be more accurate and be able to generate reports instead of us creating our own reports.
We've gone from very rudimentary capability, basically audio information, to officers in the field having computers in their cars and mobile computing devices that they can carry with them.
We have multiple shots fired downtown at Dudley Street and Emerald.
The moment an incident begins, future commanding officers will be able to see the location and status of all officers. They'll be able to access public cameras to get a visual of the suspect, then pull suspect background information to share with officers on scene.
Where is this active shooter located? Where are my fellow officers so there's no friendly fire incidents? All these details will help the officer respond for his safety and for the safety of those around him.
We see him up ahead, approaching in vehicle now. Suspect has fled. We'll have the drone follow.
Police officers of the future will be able to pursue suspects in a safer way. Using drones, they'll be able to continuously monitor a suspect's location while situating themselves in the best position to approach.
I'm looking at the live feed of him hiding. Bottom of the back staircase, number 19.
I see the feed now. I have Bateman and Owens, two blocks away. Wait for them as backup before your approach.
Police, drop your weapon! Down on the ground, face down!
Stay where you are!
Officers will be able to collect evidence with their personal communications devices, making it easy to document the incident and build a report. All of this technology will work as an integrated system, helping future officers stay safe and better serve their communities.
The technology there now is, we're pretty sure it's available, almost positive it is. It's just a matter of catching up.
The communities are getting more sophisticated and demand better and better service. So we have to find ways to make sure that we streamline, continue to make them more efficient, more effective, and oftentimes with the same number of resources.
For people to actually take note and make improvements for a police officer, not only for their safety, not only for the public safety, but also for their health, I think is a great leap forward for the police department.